LGBT community is one of many marginalized communities in this city. So to celebrate our existence, our right to exist, it's incredibly important for us to do.
And that is Sister Ruth of the Charm City Sisters, an LGBTQ rights group, at Saturday's Pride Parade. Mayor Jack Young went to the parade and took the opportunity to sign a bill regarding single occupancy bathrooms that you see in a lot of restaurants. Sometimes they're designated for men, one designated for women. Mm-hmm. This would make it gender neutral so that whatever is available, trans person, man or woman can use whatever bathroom they like. I got to tell you something. This is the policy at home. What's wrong with this?
What's wrong with this is, what are we fixing? If the restaurant owner has decided, or the business owner has decided, they want one restroom for women and one for men, and I can tell you restaurant owners I know that if you have a nice restroom for women and it consistently stays clean, you have little amenities in there, you will get women patronage to come back and forth. And men, Robert, I know you're not like this,
because you're
a very clean individual. But men are pretty destructive when it comes to restrooms.
And so having
that removal takes away my owner as of that facility ability to have something specifically that I am using to keep my patronage okay.
But at the same time, I have talked to a lot of LGBTQ and trans people as well.
I've had them on the show, Transgender Alliance.
And they feel marginalized. And this is something that, if this helps, makes those patrons comfortable, I'm going to get more business.
No. No. That's not the way I would look at it as a business owner, because I am looking at the overwhelming majority of my patronage who aren't transgender, who aren't non-binary. What I look at behind this, Robert, we can all kind of dance around this. There's a move in this country to eliminate gender as an actual type of classification. We saw it in California when they tried to remove gender off of birth certificates. And there's a real movement to try to eliminate the one thing that really does distinguish us. Let's take the non-binary and transgender people to that side. Men and women are different. And we're different biologically and importantly for a reason. And this whole attempt to me is very sinister. It really is.
And with that revelation that men and women are different, we're going to move to plastic bags.
Let's do that. They're the same.
And they're all the same.
Yes.
And Councilman Bill Henry tonight introducing legislation to ban plastic bags. There would be the 5 cents bag tax, similar to what was in place in Montgomery County. This was tried 5 years ago. Mayor Stephanie Rawlings-Blake vetoed it.
Well, the difference in this one, though, Robert, is they will actually ban plastic bags, but then they will give you, charge you 5 cents. They call it a surcharge.
The surcharge.
It's really a tax on paper bags.
This is already in place in Montgomery County.
Well, not this. They have a fee that they charge you on the bags.
For bags.
But this one would actually remove plastic. They still give plastic in Montgomery.
Yeah.
They just have a fee. This will remove plastic and then charge you for the paper bag. The paper bag is supposed to be an option away from plastic. So this bill, if Councilman Henry gets it through, will charge you 5 cents for compostable as well as paper bags.
But the idea is for you to bring your own
bag.
And
why?
People in Montgomery County do it, and people in a lot of other places do
it. Well, my thing is, when I come to the store, I'm not only paying for the items. I'm paying for the items and the ability to carry them back to my vehicle in a comfortable type of situation. Now, I have a problem with the plastic bag, but let's remove that for a second.
Okay.
The fact that you've told me that now compostable and paper bags are the more viable option, why charge me for that? This is nothing more than a tax, Robert. Now, how many times have you heard the city or people say, let's make it an incentive-laden program. Let's incentivize you to bring your own bag by giving you something like a discount or something like that. But you don't hear that, because it's always the penalty, surcharge, tax option that's on the table. This, to me, is also a hidden tax.
They talk bathrooms. They talk plastic
bags.
They talk a lot of things.
A lot of things.
Which is back tomorrow.
Thank you, Robert.
9 to 1 on WBAL, News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.